Now let's review treatments from the biological approach. First, we have drug therapy. Remember that with the development of the neuroleptics or antipsychotics, we found effective treatments for people with schizophrenia. Recall that the drugs were the phenothiazines, including chlorpromazine, and that chlorpromazine reduced the positive symptoms associated with schizophrenia, such as the delusions and the hallucinations. Recall also that we have three classes of drugs that have been used to treat depression, and those are the MAO inhibitors, the tricyclics, and the SSRIs, selective serotonin reuptake inhibitors. These have all been proven to be effective in the treatment of depression. We also discussed that the SSRIs are used to treat anxiety as well. We also mentioned briefly that the tricyclics are sometimes used for treating chronic pain and for bedwetting, and also for the treatment of ADHD. In addition, we discussed the use of both the benzodiazepines and the barbiturates in the treatment of anxiety, but that the benzodiazepines are preferred over the barbiturates because they are safer. We also discussed the long-term negative consequences of using the benzodiazepines as they are cognitive inhibitors. Also, you read about lithium and that it's been prescribed for a long time because of its ability to stabilize the mania associated with bipolar disorder. And we also have the stimulants. The stimulants help improve a person's ability to concentrate. And recall that also from the biological approach are the psychosurgeries that we discussed. Briefly, you'll recall that we talked about the prefrontal lobotomy and that it produced tragic effects and is no longer in use today. So this material here is for a historical perspective to see how far we've actually come in the area of psychology. So lobotomy, remember, is not used today. We also discussed electroconvulsive therapy, or ECT, and its use in the treatment of major depressive disorder. Recall here that an electric current is passed through the person's brain in order to induce a seizure, and afterwards people report an absence of their depression symptoms. And finally, we discussed repetitive transcranial magnetic stimulation, also for the treatment of depression. So together, for the biological approach, we had our drug therapies as well as our psychosurgeries.